blah, or whatever.
Hey, Dino fans, D-Rex here. Having a bit of a rainy day outside the studio today, and so I thought it would be a great day for a deep dive submarine adventure. Going to take a look at the deep dive submarine from Jurassic World Matchbox. We can see on the front of the package a blue ocean background with the Mossasaurus, the Jurassic World logo, the artwork with Owen and Blue, as well as an action picture on the lower right-hand corner. We can see on the front of the package a blue ocean background with the Mossasaurus, the Jurassic World logo, the artwork with Owen and Blue, as well as an action picture on the lower right-hand corner. It has a Try Me button, which activates the light inside the submarine, and the light has two settings. One setting is on, and the other setting is this flashing pattern. The action picture also says that this submarine will float, allowing you to play with it in the water. If we take a quick look at the back of the box, we'll see that it mentions the light up feature. It works with action figures sold separately and will also float and submerge, which is unusual for a toy with electronics. It has two arms on the front, which contain a grabber that is spring-loaded and a saw that actually spins. In the lower left-hand corner, we see a picture of the lights and sounds rescue rig, which I'll look at in another video a little later. Right off the bat, this toy is a little more difficult than some of the others to get out of the package. It has rubber bands holding all of its various implements and attachments in place. It has two plastic bands holding the external storage tanks in place. And the bottom, you have to cut the tape on the sides and bottom of the box and actually tear this glued flap loose and then fold it back like that and remove plastic tabs from the bottom of the box. You'll also find in the bottom of the box a set of instructions. This is longer than most other instructions, and I can assume that this toy is a little more complicated and possibly has more play features. There is a small bit of assembly that you must do before you can play with the submarine. You see it has these external tanks. You need to insert the soft rubber piece into the hard plastic end. These actually can be completely removed from the toy, but I assume that they are external tanks used for balance as well as ballast. And they do push pretty firmly in place, so they're not just going to be constantly lost. You see it has another one on the other side. You just push it into place, line up the hose with a little notch, and it sort of locks into place. And there we have it. Here is your fully assembled submarine ready for play. The submarine appears to be a very fun and interesting toy. I thought originally that these only rotated like this, but that's not the case. The saw spins, the arm rotates, and you can turn it basically any direction that you would like. The grabber arm is spring-loaded and operates much the same way. You can position it just about any way that you'd like. Having not seen the movie, but only seeing pictures, I would say that the sculpt looks fairly accurate to the movie. It has a button on the top that activates the light feature, and a hatch. You push in right at the bottom of it and lift up, and now you can place figures inside. I have not opened my Fallen Kingdom figures yet, so I grabbed Robert Muldoon for this test. But basically, it has a nice little plastic clip that the figure clips into. Put his hand on the controls. And close the lid. As I suspected when I was putting the toy together, these external tanks play prominently in the play feature in which the submarine either dives or floats. If you want the submarine to float, make sure that the rubber seal on the back is pushed very hard so that it's sealed all the way and no water will get into the center compartment, and that your tanks are sealed and locked in place. That should allow the submarine to float on water. If you want it to submerge, you open this and it allows water to come in here, and you fill the external tanks and seal them, and you should be able to submerge the deep dive submarine to the bottom of your bathtub. The good news is you're fairly safe inside your deep dive submarine. The bad news is the Isla Nublar Lagoon is not as empty as you thought it was. By the looks of the back of this box, something has survived. If you use the Try Me window, it's something that feels very real. That's right, Dino fans. On April 16th, I was very fortunate to be able to pick up my very own Jurassic World Real Feel Mosasaurus. Let's get her out of the box. Time for a little bit of real talk. This is one of the most difficult toys in the entire collection to unbox. First of all, the ends are taped, so you have to cut tape in three places and pull out all the flaps. You have to do this at both ends. This is folded under and around. You have to pull it out, but not too far. You don't want to, pull it out so it's not caught on anything anymore. And then, as if that wasn't enough, you have to reach in here and separate this because they glued it into the box. Once that's done, you can push her out. Now I have an empty box. And I should be able to cut her strings and remove her from her box. Oh man. Here she is. And it looks like there's some assembly required. In the bottom of the box, I have her tail and two bags of fins. I think that's everything out of the box. Not everything. I also found a set of instructions on the floor after I was looking around to make sure I had everything, and this time I actually am going to glance at them to make sure that I assemble her properly. It's a good thing I read the instructions. The instructions say that they have an alphabetic system for telling you which fin goes where. They have a backup system, however. I do not know if you'll be able to see this well enough. You can see it says RL. That would be rear left. This one says FL, which is front left. We have RR, which is right rear, and FR, which is front rear. Inside the figure, there are no alphabetical designations, only the two-letter designations that you can find inside the pegs on the limbs. Whether you use the two-letter designations or the alphabetical system, that is detailed on the instructions. When you lay the pieces out, they look like this. The curved bits of the fin are towards the front. The straight edges are towards the back. We have A, then B, then C, then D, and the tail. Okay, once you have figured out where all of the pieces go, attaching them is fairly easy. You line them up, peg in the hole, and push. You want to push until you hear a clicking sound. Obviously, that didn't do it. There's the clicking sound. Now this fin is in place. And once it's in place, it can rotate all the way around. We do the same with the other three fins. I finally got all four fins clicked into place. The rear ones have a more solid base to click into, so they're much easier to get in than the front ones. The front ones attach to sort of a squishy area, so you have to push a lot harder on the front than you do the back. But once you get them clicked in, as you can see, they do rotate all the way around. Very positionable. Next, we're going to line up the peg on the tail and the little notch on the tail with the hole and the slot on the back. Once again, you have to push pretty hard. As you can see, it didn't click loud enough. It's not quite attached. All right, I had to cut the video so that I could do this properly because you have to push really hard. But if you pick her up after you think you have her in place, you get the top peg. If you flip her over and there's a gap here, there's not supposed to be. What you do is you pick her up and put your thumbs on either side of the plastic housing and push as hard as you can until you hear a click. Once this piece has clicked, as well as the peg on the top side has clicked, her tail is fully attached, and she's finally ready to be played with. Aside from taking a long time and a lot of effort to assemble, for someone who doesn't have a lot of hand strength, once she's together, she's absolutely worth it. She's beautifully sculpted. She has lovely blue faded coloring with kind of a speckled, mottled, lighter blue. She has scutes on her back like a crocodile. She has scales. She has flippers that look very much like whale flippers. They move. Her jaw is poseable to the point where it can be open or closed. Inside of her mouth is sculpted and painted, and she has a lovely menacing eye. Wonderful teeth, a very crocodilian jaw. She's very beautiful, and she's very beautifully sculpted and painted, and she's quite large. For comparison, here is my Colossal Rex. If I was to remove the Colossal's tail at its pivot joint, she's about that long. So she's going to take up quite a bit of room on your space, but she is in scale with the submarine and the figures, as you're about to see. Here she is in scale with the two-man submersible. And here she is compared to Robert Muldoon. You can fit an entire figure in her mouth. Something else I wanted to show you real quick is that not only do the flippers rotate all the way around, it's a little difficult to do, but they do pivot in and out. So they're more positionable than I thought the first time. They're still stiff, which is a good thing if you want her to keep a certain position, but it's a little bit difficult to do. I don't know if a little kid's going to be able to do this by themselves successfully all the time until they get loosened up with play. Blue lighting is a lot of fun, but I wanted to get a shot of her in the normal daylight balanced light so you can see her color. You can see she has a darker blue on top, the mottled striping, the fade, down to the regular blue on her sides, and white on the bottom. Very much reminds me of a shark. And you can see the scales and the scutes again. Very reminiscent of a crocodile. If you're a fan of the Mosasaur, you're going to want to pick up these two toys. And that reason is very simple. The trailer that was just released shows the scene very briefly where these two interact in the lagoon. And if you're going to want to recreate scenes from the movie, you want to play with your Mosasaur in a way that represents what happens in the movie, you're going to need the submarine as well as the toy. Obviously, it's your choice, it's your collection. You could have one without the other, but I personally am really glad that I have both of them together. They can be displayed together. When the kids get a hold of them, they can play together. And all in all, I'm pretty happy with it. I didn't see any paint errors on mine. Nothing too crazy. Once you put the limbs on, you can't see any of the alphabetical numbering system or anything like that. I have not put my submarine in water yet. I probably won't, just because I don't want to have to clean it afterwards. But let me know in the comments if you have one and if your kids have taken it into the tub, and let me know if it floats. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and as always, like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. How did your fishing trip go, Robert? Not very well.